Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Washington football team and the Dallas Cowboys. Both of these teams about to reach the halfway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports.
And this will make it into the end zone.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
Not the start that he was looking for, as he's going to be met and dropped behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
Brings up second and 11 at the 22-yard line.
To throw. It's caught on the right side. Williams. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
Oh boy. Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Elliott. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And he takes it all the way down to the 22. A big run that time by Elliott. 43 yards. Boy, Curley stands second in the league in rushing, and runs like that are a big reason why. Heck, runs like that might get him to first.
And when you've got goals in front of you, if you're second and you want to be first, that type of running gives you something to shoot for and hopefully attain.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And this time they're able to bottle him up as he'll stop him at the line of scrimmage.
Right at the line.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Second and 10 at the 22-yard line.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. A quick throw out wide. It's McLaurin. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Fielded in the end zone.
And he returns this to the 22.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Thank you. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
He's going to drop this one down to Gibson.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards.
Brings up second and 2 at the 30-yard line.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
Nice job there utilizing his big target. And he didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Field. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and 5. Here's a quick throw out left. It's complete. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4. Could have gone with a ground game there, opted for the quick pass. Well, I don't know that it would have mattered, Charles, but it didn't work out.
In a lot of these offenses, yards after catch are built in without explicitly saying it. In this case, he didn't make anyone miss out on the perimeter. Got tackled behind the line of scrimmage.
And brings up 4th down.
At their own 20-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start 1st and 10. They'll start the drive with Elliott. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23.
Ezekiel Elliott.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
On 2nd down, Elliott takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
Ezekiel Elliott, the ball carrier.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
An extra man here in the secondary for Washington on 3rd down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he finds McLaurin. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Terry McLaurin, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. So on 3rd and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
Taken in the end zone, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
Their own 25-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
The 25-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. They'll set up a throw. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 11 yards there. First down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll set up to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. 39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 25-yard line. And it's caught right at the 10-yard line. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6.
Cowboys 10.
It's another first down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year.
And Washington has made this a one-score game.
No going for two. They'll kick the point after. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now.
Makes the score Cowboys 10, Washington 7.
So just a three-point game now as they send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Cowboys take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A big play on the ground there. It goes for 36 yards.
The 39-yard line.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They'll run with Elliott. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
They give those 2 yards right back, and now they're looking at a third and 10.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he... ...was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up fourth. And the coach has decided to throw the red flag. He will challenge this play. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself. but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
And he's got this one across midfield in the Cowboy territory. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Second and two.
They'll try the left side. Gibson, he'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Antonio Gibson.
The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Third down, it's Gibson. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Move the chains, a gain of 7 on third down. That right there, a good sign for a team that's had trouble converting third down so far this year. They're in the bottom 5 in the NFL, but they come through there.
Yeah, and I bet if we put our guy Marvin on the case and say, Marvin, tell us where they rank on third and what, right? I bet they're in the top 5 in the league. I'm 3rd and 5, 3rd and 6, 3rd and 7 or more, because that's how you end up not converting.
And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. And Daniil Hunter, he's the one who gets in there and brings him down to the ground. So after the sack here, 2nd and 14. Play action. They'll throw. Looking left sideline. It's complete. And they move this all the way down to the 9.
Caught by number 10.
Give them 32 on the play.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be 2nd and goal.
12-yard line.
They'll try again on 2nd and goal after going backwards to the 12. Play action fake. They'll look to throw. And he'll get this to Antonio Gibson complete. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
Complete.
That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a 3rd and goal.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
2 minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. Coming up at halftime, we remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. From 8 yards out. And Washington has taken the lead.
The kicker on.
CD for them. This has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position?
It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Cowboys! Terry McLaurin, 83 yards. And the Cowboys have retaken the lead. Just give it up the lead, and they get it right back.
Yeah, how about that? Answered quickly. Got right back to it, and look, long drives have their place. We know that. They can wear teams down. But when you hit them with big plays like that, that can really be a shot to them, a big-time one.
Yeah, one play, but now your defense is probably saying, man, we could have used a little more rest over here.
Washington will take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
There have been points on the board. We just saw back-to-back touchdown drives. I love it. I'm high-fiving our statistician, Christian McLeod, and you're angry. You're a defensive guy.
If you met one of my defensive coordinators, God rest his soul, I'm surprised he isn't in this booth right now wanting to really take you on. This is not football the way he sees it. He wants
him.
A good old-fashioned kicking game, defense, field position, and we're getting an up-and-down-the-field game here.
I'll take him. Where's his tombstone?
Boot Hill, baby.
On first down, Gibson. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brings up second and 12.
Second and 12 now at the 44-yard line. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Lewis. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
You're trailing. You're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side with that good field position they just took over with. First down carry by Elliott. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
At the 28-yard line.
Here on first and 10 on the RPO, that's complete right side, and he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
A few moving pieces on that play because that was an RPO, was it not?
It was, but one important piece that didn't move incorrectly, the offensive line. Because when you're running this play, as he continued down the line of scrimmage, sometimes the lineman can wander downfield. If you're more than a yard downfield, it's illegal to throw the football at that point. But they held their ground, held their spot, and turned it into a nice gain.
In their bag of tricks.
And isn't that always tough to watch when they score and you see the excitement and then when they realize those points aren't going to count? Can they get it back together and find their way back to the end zone?
A terrible spot for a holding call as they'll try again, but now from further back on first and goal. Looking to throw. That's complete right around the 8. And here he'll get it down to the 7. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. This just a 24-yard attempt. And his kick is right there. It's good. So we have reached halftime in what's a 6-point game at the break. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. Washington down on the scoreboard, but they are getting the football first here, and we are back underway on EA Sports. Fielded in the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result had he opted for the touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. Looking right sideline, that's complete. He continues to deliver a first down here. He had 4 catches in the first half, and this one number 5. Back to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left. It's caught inside the 25. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Now, we know this offense has the potential to strike quickly, and they just bit off 2 huge plays on back-to-back snaps.
So on the other side of the ball, you've got to go Band of Brothers thought process. No one left behind. No pointing fingers, no accusations, because if you don't, those quick strikes we just saw, they become long-lasting.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total.
A gain of 12. First down, Washington.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Fake. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well. Umpire through the flag usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
Now they face a 2nd and long following the holding penalty. He'll drop to throw. His throw caught right around the 6.
Touchdown.
And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. An 18-yard touchdown grab. And Washington has tied the ball game with the extra point still to come. The point after here coming up. And his kick is good, but flags come in. Looks like we're going to get a roughing call here on the follow-through. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Here's Jarvis Landry now on the return. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19.
At their own 19-yard line.
He can just kind of sense the momentum turning here. It's first and 10. They start on the ground with Elliott. Got a first down and more past the 30. And all the way up to the 31-yard line. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs, because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses. Those exact type of runs.
And this is going to be a Cowboys first down as he'll get this up to about the 42.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
They'll run on first down. Elliott. Ezekiel Elliott going to take it the distance. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Cowboys have once again taken the lead. Now Mike McCarthy saying, let's go for two. He's been having a great game, and that one right there, his best run so far, and it ends with 6 points.
And not only that, in his mind, what is he thinking? Can I get to 200 yards as well? Because he knows he's closing in on it. He may not know the exact number, but the best runners have a feel of what the yardage is that they're compiling, and he knows that he's getting close to that 200-yard mark now.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
We'll take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
On third down. It's Gibson, and he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. They get the first. The decision to run on third and medium winds up being a good one.
First down, Washington.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. A lot of talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it, and not realizing that danger lurks while you're doing so. And there's your end result right there. Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, Their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Given three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Out of the gun now on third down. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. Picked by Kendall Fuller. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to fire one deep over. He's got a man complete. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Washington. A big play there. 85 yards.
And Washington now an extra point away from tying this thing up.
Well, this is exactly where I expect teams to take a shot. Right after a turnover, you count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels, and that's exactly what they did there. They threw it downfield and really created a big play.
Yeah, you said jumbled. They were the definition of jumbled defensively. One play and into the end zone. So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10.
Flush to his right. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Slings this deep from McLaurin. It's caught inside the 25. And all the way down to the 22-yard line.
And we continue to see another example here of offenses just going for it.
And this game has really turned into a receiver's dream and a defender's nightmare because no one's being stopped throwing the ball downfield and points are going on the board.
And quickly to the outside, that's caught by Lamb.
And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard and it's second down.
At the 20-yard line.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked.
Jonathan Allen, a 7-yard loss, brings up third down.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Cowboys on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 16. Open man Lamb. It's complete. He'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark it down at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 9-yard line.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Second and goal at the 5-yard line.
From the shotgun again to Elliott. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott with touchdown number 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Cowboys have broken the tie. Point after, right down the middle. And they will take a 7-point lead.
10-28.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
They're on 24-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And now after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. They go play action here on first down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Xavier Woods with a pick. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7. Leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, and all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
It's a gain of a run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz. Pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get.
And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. 24 yards. And the Cowboys turn that interception into a touchdown. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those 3 touchdowns, it's got him in the lead. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Over 1st and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And last time wasn't pretty. 1 play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. The 20. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A big play there. 78 yards. And Washington able to make this a close game again. So that's a really big play here in the fourth quarter. And don't look now, they're right back in this game.
Did it feel to you, as it did to me, that maybe they were a little bit soft in what they were lining up with on defense? Almost like they were protecting the lead rather than trying to make a play.
And now that lead is down to just 1 score.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here. So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. This is Elliott. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Second and 11 at the 27-yard line.
On second down now, it's Elliott. And he'll get about four as he's brought down at the 24. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. They'll try the sweep with Elliott. And that's not going to get it done. He'll come up well short of the first at about the 21.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside, or they can really shred your defense.
So that's a big one. Obviously, Charles makes it a two-score game, his third field goal of the game, able to knock it through.
Yeah, not exactly free and clear yet, but as a defense, you get to play a little bit looser, don't you? Because you do now have a little bit of a margin of error, don't you?
The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
At their own 33-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quick. This is caught inside the 15. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. A big play there. 67 yards. And Washington has made this a one-score game. They'll look to throw. His pass caught at the four. And he is going to lose yardage here.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us. Because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at one.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
They'll try and run some clock now with Elliott. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
After the penalty, it's Elliott. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apke. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown. This game, it's been defensively oriented on both sides, so I guess it stands to reason that the play of the game comes on defense.
Well, it's my kind of game. You know that.
That's
anytime
right.
We have
that's
a defensive
right.
battle. But that, as you said, it stands to reason that's the way the game tilted. Someone had to make a big play, and the way the defenses were dominating, that's exactly what we got.
They're going to try and run, and he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more.
48, Cowboys 45.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this will make it into the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
At their own 22-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. On first down, it's Elliott, and he'll get this one up to the 26. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
They go to Elliott again. Less than two to play with just a field goal separating these two sides. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
He's back to throw, eluding the pressure right. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
They'll run on first down. Gibson fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Gibson, and he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10.
Third down.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. They give him 16 yards there, and it's a Washington first down. That catch puts him 80 away from 1,000. He's now at 920, and 920, that ties him with Torrey Holt.
That's a great name to remember, but the number, 920, almost boggles the mind, doesn't it?
And he's across for the touchdown, and in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Cowboys take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off near the 42. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch counterpunch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
Looks like he'll throw here. Throwing left side, it's complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. It's a gain of 15, and that ought to just about put an end to this one.
Come on now, let's do this!
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Back to throw here. This pass caught at the 4. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, 2nd and 2. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Washington, they remain one of the hottest teams out there as the win moves them to 6-1. And they'll have another road date next week with the Carolina Panthers. Meanwhile, for the Cowboys, the loss drops them back to 4-3 so far. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Cleveland.
She right got me. didn't want to be so you gotta go berserk.
Okay. Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe, one to keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that want to keep you where you've been before. But I can't go, no, I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need a check, not the sneakers, but the ones that make you watch your step. You know, I sat down with my accountant. He said, I got good news and I got bad news.
Okay.
I said, what's the good news? He said, the good news is you made a lot.
Okay.
I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more.
Okay.
Look, sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but ain't from the bay. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay. But wait, jugging on the main stage with the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a vacay, meditate, hydrate, protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature.
Boss.
I don't want to seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle pockets, LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I want to see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that. It's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where your permit. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe. Oh. Men gon' lie, women gon' lie. You're looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, then you need to go open up the briefcase, see with your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa times, but they never spend a day in the rain in the front line.
No lie, no lie.
Stop playing on my phone line. Pull up in the space coupe with the roof optional. Wonder why they follow suit. I've been groomed from the womb. Came out of my mama with some running tennis shoes. Faster than the speed and bullet.
Nah, 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 nah. It's cool, it's cool.
Don't play with it, play.
Say, so what you gon' do?
Hey yo,
yeah.
Nike check. I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chests coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Get the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. Jay like, hold up, wait a minute, like don't make sense, don't really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that JT finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey yo, Nike check. T-shirt check. Sneakers check. Socks check. Hoodie check. Shorts check. Nike check. I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. Shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Get the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist, gonna stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. Going up sky high while I'm rocking Air Force. And she just wanna ride, shorty bad and gorgeous. She was rocking stripes, said it's alright. Then I cut her off, shorty stepped on my off-whites. Okay, now wait, wait, wait. Gotta get the bag and racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't, I'ma say. Got a new press, those and the J's in the way. Got a new wrist watch, ready, don't take time. Might pull up on a hop if it's up too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot. Boy, this my court, got a block on lock. I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist, going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They like, hold up, wait a minute, like don't make sense, don't really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey, hey yo. Nike
Rocky check.
Minimal syllables, yeah. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fateful mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Reflux, I drip out from the socket, so a teacup, drink up inside, look when they peep us, juice us in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn, black hawk, see the red dawn, horizon, blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction, my thoughts still rising, thinking, what type of knowledge don't sink in, life gives you lemons and my only thought is drinking, thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30, that's all that concerns me early, lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage, way before they pouring on my grave, minute made, let it set my...
We'll be right back.
From the site that many call the loudest in the NFL, we are inside Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle with their opponents. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Arrowhead.
And this carries into the end zone. And he returns this to the 22.
On the return, the Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
First down with Hurts. Caught by the tight end Hurts. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 13 yards on the game's opening play.
First down, Eagles.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. First carry of the game, and he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Second down, here's Hurts. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. He's got the hookup here to DeSean Jackson. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 49-yard line. They'll run with Sanders. And down to the 44, 5 yards that time.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. From the gun, it's Hurts. And he finds his tight end, it's Hurts. And all the way inside. inside the 15 before they drop him. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? Well, how about the passing numbers so far on this first drive?
Oh, no doubt about it. They're flinging it around pretty successfully. And look at the start. The confidence level that we see in him rising because he's hit a few early. And how about the last one? The big shot right there.
Zone now. They'll look to throw. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. It was Frank Clark that time who got in there to bring him down.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. The Mississippi State man, Chris Jones, with a sack there. Charles, a little bit of feast or famine on this drive. They moved the ball okay, but they've been sacked twice now.
And they've got to figure out how to plug that leak a little bit, right? Keep them away from the quarterback, because when he's not being hit, as you mentioned, they're moving the ball well.
Four steps, and the pressure gets to him again.
A loss of 5 yards.
So on comes the Eagle kicker, Jake Elliott, on fourth down. We're scoreless after one.
With no score. Jake Elliott on for the field goal. A 48-yard attempt.
The kick by Elliott is good. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So still no touchdowns in the first half, but we do have some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game, because anytime you get to the red zone and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this one, being able to kick field goals means you're right there, and then you're just looking for that big break to take you over the top.
And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
21-yard line.
Will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 21.
Hey, check mark 47. Check mark 47.
Let's go.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. It's caught inside the 25. Mahomes finding Hill for a big play. 58 yards.
That's a big-time pitch and catch right there. And partner, I remember the days when quarterbacks would try this. They were holding their breath. But nowadays, they're counting on their receiver to be just a little bit better than the defensive back when it's one-on-one and the ball's in the air like that.
On first down, Mahomes. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 29, the 40, the 30, 10. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD.
Jake Elliott.
They were in a very good position to come up with a go-ahead score there. A really good drive. Instead, it turns into 6 points going the other way. Psychologically, I don't know what that's going to do to them.
So as a coach, you're looking at that as at least a 10-point swing, right? Because they had the field goal in their back pocket.
They certainly did, and you're right. At least a 10-point swing, maybe more.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Across the 10 before being taken down. They needed some breathing room. He gave it to him. 11 yards and a first down.
Or just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender. Somehow, they didn't get that communicated well, and it turned into a nice play.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. He'll get this complete to Jalen Reagor. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
Eagle first down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Hurts. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. It was Tyrann Mathieu, the Honey Badger, there to knock it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all. As we will make our way to the two-minute warning.
No gain on the play. And it's third down.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Deep ball for Goodwin. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Complete. Marquise Goodwin, 70 yards. And the Eagles add on to their lead. I love watching Goodwin play. Of course, everybody knows the story of him being an Olympian. He's a long jumper,
yes,
right?
Yes.
But you know that he has that athleticism, that big playability.
He certainly does. And not only was he an Olympian as a long jumper, married to a sprinter. How about that for speed in one family? And I love his end zone celebrations now. When he does go deep and beat someone for a touchdown, now he does the long jump as his celebration. Pretty cool deal.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
At their own 22-yard line.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield. And all the way down to the 36-yard line. Mahomes finding his tight end Kelce for a big one. 42 yards. On play action, it's Mahomes. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 26 big yards on that one. It's another first down. A first trip to the red zone for KC. They've got a first and 10 at the 11. Mahomes going to fire this out wide to Hill. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes finding Tyreek Hill, and the Chiefs are able to draw a bit closer. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camp. Do you remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room? This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played.
First and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Too far downfield, something those linemen have to watch out for, and that time it costs them. Now a carry for Sanders. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Give him a couple on the run there. It'll be second and 13.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle, and that's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Deep ball for Goodwin. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. 20.
Go time, baby.
Touchdown, Philadelphia! Marquise Goodwin, as the first half is winding down, and the Eagles add 6 to their lead. That's a pretty quick response to that last touchdown drive, and it seemed like they had maybe given up momentum. Not so fast.
No, not at all, because they end up pushing the lead up once again, and you're exactly right. Thought momentum might have been shifting. Instead, they grabbed old Mo, didn't let him get to the opposite sideline.
And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And going deep for Hill. That's caught at the 25.
Oh, my.
And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill in the final seconds of the first half. And the Chiefs strike quickly here for 6 points. Well, this could be a big turnaround. They get the touchdown here in the final moments of the second quarter. And remember, Charles, they're going to get the ball to start quarter number three as well.
So what you're saying is if they take the ball down to start the second half and score again, it could change the entire complexion of this game, couldn't it?
Absolutely.
Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas City.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there.
Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there.
It's over.
Pass
it's
to over. 20. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
Jake Elliott on for the point after.
Boy, the action just coming fast and furious right now. If you got up to go get a drink from the fridge, you picked the wrong time. Two long touchdowns.
Yeah, and that's how you answer a one-play drive with a one-play drive of your own. And you're exactly right. If you step away from the action, my dad took me to a Major League Baseball game when I was 8. I needed to go to the bathroom. Of course, while we were in the bathroom, Grand Slam home run.
It tends to happen that way, doesn't it?
Yeah, my dad still hasn't forgiven me.
It'll be the Chiefs football to begin quarter number 3, and they trail here as we are back underway now on EA Sports. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time.
That's
true. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
And going deep for Hill. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. He was looking for Tyreek Hill that time. And that'll bring up second down.
At the 21-yard line.
Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be taken down right around the 27. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. Give him the 3rd down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
1st and 10 at the 31-yard line.
They go play fake. Mahomes. And Mahomes misfires again, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles take advantage of good field position on the turnover to cash this one in.
The kick is good.
Elliott Good with a PAT. And the lead is now 24.
Chiefs 14. Jake Elliott.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Over 1st and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, You need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball. But surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Third quarter action from Kansas City, second down and 10. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Complete, the tight end Kelce. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Travis Kelce, 55 yards. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead. Andy Reid, never one to shy away from taking chances. He'll go for two. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further.
Chiefs, 22.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Offense set to begin their next drive. Their lead down to two scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. Throwing is Hurts. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards.
First down, Philadelphia.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Deep ball for Goodwin. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked up by Juan Thornhill. And he'll be stopped shy of the 15 at the 14-yard line on the return. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. They come in off a touchdown drive the last time they had the ball. That cut down the lead. Now the defense does their part, got them the football back.
So now maybe with the touchdown they scored previously, plus their defense making that stand up and getting the...
It got his man complete! And they finally get him down at the other 46. Mahomes finding his tight end Kelce for a big one. And even 40 yards.
36-yard line.
Mahomes now on first down. This is caught inside the 15. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 46 yards. And thanks to the interception, the Chiefs offense cashes in with six. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Dancing to his left. Now he'll pull it down, and he will get into the end zone to cut the lead a little bit further.
Eagles 38, Chiefs 30. Harrison Butker to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Taken in the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles. Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. It's caught inside the 25. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. DeSean Jackson, 75 yards. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. And the lead will grow by one more.
Makes the score Eagles 45, Chiefs 30. Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
At their own 31-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace.
Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Well, Fletcher Cox, he's been doing this for a lot of years, and another sack to his ledger there. After the sack on first down, Mahomes. That's caught. It's DeMarcus Robinson.
Mahomes pass.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
It's a gain of six. Brings up third and 13.
Throwing now is Mahomes. Mahomes hit. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And he'll get this back down to about the 12.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you. If I finally starting to realize, never give up and coincide. I can't watch TV, it's all a lot. Tired of trying, go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? Right, I don't got time. Infrastructure, right, I don't got time. I could it's all too. We're talking about your brother protecting the sons and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that.
From the site that many call the loudest in the NFL, we are inside Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up with the Washington football team. And they've got it. They recovered it. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down.
They were a little too excited to get the football, touched it before it went 10 yards.
And that's so difficult, isn't it? Because sometimes you can just take a bad hop and veer into your lane or into your body. In this case, though, they touched it before 10. Illegal touching is the call.
And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down.
Now that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, on maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
It's a gain of a yard. And it's third down.
Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute.
to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen, escaping the pressure right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. And their inaugural sack of the game coming from an unlikely source.
You mean it wasn't a linebacker? It wasn't a defensive end?
It was somebody like you.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that's a surprise for the offense. That's not what they normally get when they think about pressure.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Shotgun snap to Allen. Slings this deep from McLaurin. And that is going to be incomplete. Washington goes for it, but it does not pan out. And this crowd loves it as their guys hold on the opening drive. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. Off of play action, he'll look to throw. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Good. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line.
Looking to throw is Mahomes. Steps away to his left. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
They go play action. Now Mahomes. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked by Kendall Fuller. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You going to let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Not much there, only a yard. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. From the gun, it's Allen, flushed out right. To the right side and complete to Thomas. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. A little risky there when you roll out of that pocket right like he did. You complete the pass, but you don't get anything out of it.
But how many times have we seen when a quarterback exits out of the pocket, doesn't matter if they go left or right, the defense loses its leverage, right? There's a little chaos back there, and receivers come open. Great discipline on that play. They didn't let that happen.
And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by Juan Thornhill. And he will take it across midfield and down to the 45.
Partner, when you're playing cover two, this is like a tag team for the safeties. Each of them gets a half-field responsibility. Their job, stay as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, read the football, and go make a play. In this case, the free safety made the best play, an interception.
56 to Mike.
Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Give him 15 yards on that one. Kansas City has a first down.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for 12 yards into Kansas City first.
First and 10 at the 18-yard line.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes, flush to his right. And this is going to be intercepted.
picked off by Landon Collins. And he will be out of bounds on what will wind up being the final play of this first quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. There was a little space there, yes, but that was a well-executed run by the rookie.
It was, and he wasn't one of the higher-rated rookie running backs coming out. He's probably on the next tier. But let me tell you something. If he becomes more consistent and continues to have that drive to be one of the best, we'll see more of that in the future.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
He'll get about four as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
4 yards. And the Washington first down.
Here's McKissick. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a first down for Washington on a pickup of 11.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get them. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
Now left side on the swing pass. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
15 yards on the play, first down. Operating from the gun. Allen throwing the out route and complete. That's Thomas. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington.
Touchdown, Washington.
Logan Thomas, 36 yards. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon.
It's good, and Washington will take a 7-0 lead.
7, Chiefs nothing.
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it?
The 42-yard line.
Play action. Now it's Mahomes. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Well, they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelsey. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. eluding the pressure right. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
Let's go, defense. Just get out the field, defense. Mike 56, Mike 56. Curl it. 56, the Mike boys, 56. Check 56.
Mahomes going to go on fourth down. He is going to find Hill here. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll throw. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Kendall Fuller there on the coverage.
From the 21, it's second and 10. On play action, it's Mahomes. That's going to be caught. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Final shot before the half from Mahomes. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Mecole Hardman as time expires in the first half. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. They'll throw now on the final play. And he's going to go down. So they pass up the field goal attempt to go for six, but as a result, they leave points on the field, and that's going to do it for this first half. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three.
Justin Hopkins to kick off for Washington.
It'll be the Chiefs football to begin quarter number three, and they trail here as we are back underway now on EA Sports. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
17-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally.
Under pressure, they got him again. Montez Sweat able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. To try again after the sack. Mahomes buying time to his left. He'll hit Watkins on the crossing route. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 36 yards on the play.
Chiefs. First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
Mahomes now on first down. Rolling to his head. A big loss here as he's taken down. Montez Sweat getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon. After the sack on first down, Mahomes on the run. He'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
They go play fake. Mahomes. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short. And it's fourth down. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Chiefs tried it, but they're turned away on fourth down. And Washington will have it on the turnover on downs. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going, so what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 12 yards there and a first down.
A gain of 12. And the Washington first down.
They will run it. It's McKissick. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he won't get much. Maybe a couple. Down inside the 35 to the 34-yard
line. Brandon, one thing about blitzes, they really confuse offensive linemen at times, and what you have to do is lock in on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle ended up making the play.
Allen going to try and throw on third down. Got an open man, finds Gibson. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 22. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. We're back now in KC. Three tight ends in the ballgame here on first and 10. This one's still anybody's ballgame. It's a one-point difference here as we begin the fourth quarter play. And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside, as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down.
Second and 10 at the Chiefs' 22-yard line.
To throw, it's Allen. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the gun, Allen looking for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington.
To Terry McLaurin.
Terry McLaurin, 28 yards. And Washington able to stretch that lead out even further. And it's up. It's good. Our score, 14-6.
Chiefs, 6.
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one-possession game, down 8. They'll be looking for the touchdown and 2-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage. This is caught inside the 15. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 73 yards. And the Chiefs are a 2-point conversion away from tying this thing up.
But they certainly aren't afraid to dial up the long ball, and fans dig the long ball. And they absolutely needed it, and guess what? They got it. How about that?
And now, 2-point conversion away from tying this game up. Shotgun snap to Mahomes, escaping the pressure right. And he will get into the end zone for 2, and this game now tied here in the 4th.
Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. On first down, Gibson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
On the pickup, it's second and inches.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Gibson, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
They'll run with McKissick. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. It'll be a gain of two, and speaking of twos, it'll take us to the two-minute warning.
Brings up second and eight.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a score to break this tie. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. It'll be a gain of four, and that'll lead here to a third down.
Short gain, last two plays. Who do you think's excited about that?
Absolutely, this defense, they're saying go right ahead with those. To throw is Allen. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 34-yard line. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of seven. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. They'll keep it on the ground. Gibson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a third and three. A carry now for McKissick. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. Right back to him on first down. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two.
All right, my man, this is now where it's risk-reward. Because on defense, you've got to crowd the line of scrimmage. You've got to get in all the gaps, get up tight on everyone, and try and force the field goal attempt here. You can't let them break one big, but you know something, when you crowd the line of scrimmage, they do pop one, it's going
to
go away.
Yeah, as I say, could take it to the house, but the magnitude of this possible upcoming field goal, every yard counts. And this will be a gain of six when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21.
He's brought down at the 15-yard line.
And they're going to get the timeout called. What a finish. We're down to 4 seconds to go in this football game. So now it all comes down to Dustin Hopkins.
A 32-yard attempt.
And his kick is indeed good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. So he's able to come through in a hostile environment, and you'd have to imagine that's the game winner.
Yeah, how about that? And the way that this game's gone, you think they really wanted to get to overtime and take their chances there? They wanted to get this thing done. When you're the visitor, you don't want to play into overtime. You want to knock it down, get it done, and go home.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to...
And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Today's finals...